So to me, presidential elections are a lot like ordering massage from an unfamiliar out-call service near your hotel. You sit in your room hoping someone calm and professional will show up to cater to your peculiar needs. But sure enough, they're never like the picture in the phone book. Sometimes they're not even from the same country. And what's with the Adam's apple? I ordered one. So instead you get creeps. But by the time they're in your room, it's already too late. And you're out $300, sometimes four, in Manhattan, $550, plus tip. Don't put it on your credit card. I learned. Back to the presidency. The very nature of the desire to run our country selectively eliminates the sane people and caters only to the egomaniacal. Look at the recent candidates. Bill Clinton, John Edwards, Donald Trump, Jonathan Albert, the Impaler Sharky. All egos on life support. The folks who are truly smart, creative, tough, and moral tend to sit this thing out. Perhaps they realize it's not worth it, or maybe they already have a great job. More than likely, their ego doesn't need a hefty stroke, which is why it requires America to pursue the people they want to lead them, which is why I'm asking Congressman Thaddeus McCotter to consider tossing his hat into the ring. Look how excited he is. In my mind, he's one of the few polls who seems less interested in impressing celebrities or making cheap points of sentimentality than preserving the freedoms unique to our delightful island nation. And this is not an endorsement, mind you, and I'm not even allowed to vote since the incident in the public library, which I've apologized four times for. But I'm just saying, Congressman, please make this interesting, if anything, so I can get a free campaign button. It's a perfect clasp for my shorty robe. And if you disagree with me, then you, sir, are worse than Hitler. Gregalogue. Welcome back. Let's find out if we've got anything wrong so far. For that, we'll go to TV's Andy Levy. So, Andy, it's been so long. Where were you?
No, nowhere special. I just had a bunch of meetings.
Really? You spent the whole time in a conference room? I find that hard to believe.
No. The whole thing was on a yacht.
Whose yacht?
I don't really want to say, but the name of the boat was Roops.
So you know RuPaul?
Yeah, not exactly, Greg.
Well, you'll be glad to know the show did swimmingly without you.
Well, look, I'm glad I'm leaving it in good hands. Left it in good hands, I mean.
Well, it's good you're back and we can start planning for the future.
Absolutely. I've got a lot to do between now and the fall.
I'm caught in the middle.
Don't worry, he can have you.
Don't want him.
Where do I go? Ooh, Hannity on line one.
Gregalogue, Republican candidate, it's not exciting anyone. Congressman McCotter, if drafted, I will not serve. Just so you know.
That's very disappointing. Even if we turn the Oval Office into Al Gore's library.
Doesn't matter.
What if they create a first cat?
Well, then maybe we can talk.
Okay. Oh. I knew that would get to his heart.
Anthony, you said you've given hundreds of thousands of dollars to Trump's campaign through your gambling. Yes. I feel like you might be lowballing.
Yeah. It's probably more like a million. Yeah. I would say overall, probably. Does that give me like a cabinet position or something?
I think it might, yeah.
Well, it does mean you have a problem.
Oh, right.
I'm hopefully not Secretary of the Treasury.
Yeah, true.
I'd do better than Geithner.
That's true. Yeah.
Says the snarky right-winger.
Who knows absolutely nothing about Tim.
Yeah, exactly. That was just something that the part of my brain spit out, and I don't even know what it means.
It's been 4 years, man.
I know.
Sometimes it just comes out.
Yeah.
Jedediah, you said there's a real anti-establishment feel to the mood of the voters these days. So, Gary Johnson?
Yeah, I don't know about that one.
But there's,
you know, that might be a, well, I don't know. You know what? Anything's possible. Donald Trump's out there right now, and if you had told me that he was going to be out there a couple of years ago, I would have said no way. So you know what? Let's leave it to the voters.
Hey, Andy, when you were asking that question to Jedediah, do you know who was laughing uncontrollably to my left? Congressman McCotter.
Well,
that's
really?
Because Anthony was tickling him.
What's your problem with Governor Gary Johnson, Congressman McCotter?
Oh, legalize it, Mon. Yeah, there's not much of a national agenda.
I think that's a slight to a guy who served two terms as governor to suggest that's his entire agenda, sir.
Well, President
Levy,
may I
remind you that you're under oath? May I remind you that you're under oath, sir? May I remind you that you're under oath?
May I remind you that you're underneath my dignity to respond to?
You don't need to remind me of that. Anthony, you said you're for change this time around and that you'll take Obama's word for it.
Absolutely. What can I say?
Well, I'm waiting for him to run against himself from the first term, the way he ran against Bush the last time around. And he could say he's going to close Gitmo, unlike the guy who was just president in the last 4 years. He could say no military tribunals, unlike the guy who was president for the last 4 years, etc.
Yeah, and also he could say that last guy change didn't come fast enough.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yep. He can even use "you keep the change," meaning his old change, and so bring out some new change.
Yeah. Clever. Yeah.
Also, the last guy didn't really change the culture in D.C., I don't think. So he can promise to do that.
Well, he can run against old Obama or even Trump, but he's still going to win.
I think you're probably right.
I think I am, too.
No, not happening.
No, we'll see. Red Eye wrap-up. First of all, awesome.
Yeah.
Greg, my bad for writing the phrase "dope joint" in your script. I won't do that again.
That's all right. I enjoyed stumbling over it.
Yeah.
Gary Johnson enjoyed smoking it.
Yes.
Exactly. Jedediah, you said conservatives should do some rap videos of their own, and thankfully Greg pointed out that was a really bad idea.
No, not a rap video. I said McCotter on guitar, dude. I mean, that's a whole different level of musicality there. Yes.
Come on, Andy. I'll even let you play on it, Mr. Keyboard Player. I'll use both hands, even.
Listen, Andy, if I can get kids to start singing about the Constitution and getting into the groove, I'm all for it.
Okay.
No matter how you got to do it. Right.
See, I would find that irritating.
Yeah, I've had teachers like you.
Yeah. I'm completely opposed
I was a teacher, if you'll recall.
I'm completely opposed to all of this.
Yeah.
Congressman McCotter, you said you found the videos to be discordant dung, and that if liberals think they're the RT ones, they should be disabused of that notion. Should point out that the EPA's rap was recorded by a guy named Ted Coopwood, who was named a point of light by your personal hero, President George H.W. Bush.
Well, if you're citing him as an expert on what rocks and what doesn't, you're the one with the problem.
I'm just pointing out who he is.
Thank you for that.
You're welcome. Oh, and Marla Gibbs is not dead.
Oh, thank God. I love that woman.
Yes. She has a movie in post-production right now called The Last Laugh, which stars Tony Rock, who I believe was a former Red Eye guest.
Yes, he's Chris Rock's cousin or something. Right?
Yeah, that was back in the day when we just didn't even bother going after people and went after their relatives.
Absolutely.
Yes. Yeah. We had, I think that same week we had Sarah Silverman's sister, and that's not a joke.
And didn't we have Eddie Murphy's brother, Charlie?
No, we never did.
No, we never did.
Oh, he turned us down?
He turned us down, for sure.
We actually turned him down.
Oh, we turned him down?
Yeah.
I feel bad about that.
Yeah.
And how their careers have blossomed.
Yes.
Kate Walsh says Americans who think offshore drilling will decrease our dependency on foreign oil are misinformed. Congressman, you said this is classic liberalism, that if you disagree with them, you're misinformed. Here's the thing, though. Isn't she kind of right? America has between 2-3% of the world's oil reserves, but we consume 25% of the world's oil. So any reduction in the dependency on foreign oil that we would gain from offshore drilling, which I support, would be tiny, wouldn't it?
It would certainly be better than nothing, and what it does is leads to a responsible transition towards a green energy future, which is done by the free market, not by the hand of government, and certainly not by cold turkey, which would destroy jobs and would increase costs throughout households in America. And I read that at Salon, which I found laying in Al Gore's library.
Don't get me wrong. I say drill the out of the planet. That's not my thing.
Andy,
are single.
I have to correct you on one thing. Please. We have more than 2% of the world's oil reserves. That does not count ANWR, the Outer Continental Shelf, or shale we have in Wyoming, Colorado, or Utah.
I think we're 3% with all of
3%
that.
3% with all that? I'm going to have to double check that, but I think it might be a little higher.
That's the only figure I could find, but I...
Obama's out there saying 2%, and I know that's wrong
for a fact. If I can, I would also bet that she'd be against utilizing natural gas, she'd be against using our coal reserves, she'd be against any type of domestic...
Hey, I have to heat my pool this summer.
Yeah.
It takes a lot. I get that thing up to like 95 degrees. Yeah. It's wonderful. Yeah. Love it.
Which is weird. Anthony, I actually kind of agree with you on this, which absolutely terrifies me, by the way.
Yeah, that is horrifying.
I think we will have a replacement for oil the minute we need it.
Yeah, right. Only when we need something do we invent it. We're amazing.
Anthony, I just worry that time is now.
He looks like the sleepy kitten.
If I can, if we only invent things when we need them, how come there's red eye?
It's a backhanded insult.
It is.
Better question. Why do we have you on the show?
Because you couldn't get Charlie Murphy.
Because we couldn't get your brother.
You couldn't handle my brother. Man. And Bill's time.
Gotta go. Just lastly, Bill, I think a lot of America knows who Kate Walsh is. That was a weird thing for you to say.
Really? I swear to God, I've never heard of her.
No.
She sounds like every...
And I speak for America.
I've never heard of her either. I have to agree with Bill, which is a rare occurrence.
Yeah. This is a red eye. This
she's
is popular.
I'm just saying she was on two really popular TV shows.
Wait a second. What you're hearing right now is you're hearing from a guy who sits at home with his cats and watches Private Practice.
No, yes, I don't. But I actually know who she is because of her work with the Upright Citizens Brigade.
All right. Well, I choose to go out and exercise my alcoholism, sir. So okay. I would not be aware of this Kate Walsh you speak of.
Go.
All right. See you later.
Bye. That does it for today's adventure. If you're new here, please subscribe. Take it one step further and ring that notification bell. And if you enjoyed today's video, please give it a big old like and a thumbs up. It lets me know you care. I'll see you in the next video. Ride on.